Ladies and gentlemen, the Trondheim Symphony Orchestra is going to tell you a story tonight. First, you will hear the harp telling you what time it is. She plays the 12 strokes of midnight. It's not any midnight, it's Halloween. And at this point, Death himself enters and plays his melody on his strange tuned instrument. Little by little, all the dead people start to rise from their graves and they start to dance to Death's melody. You can literally hear the skeletons dancing, played by the xylophone. And all the dead people, they dance all night, but the dance is suddenly interrupted by a big tam-tam. And you will hear a cockerel's crow, played by the oboe. It's dawn, and all the dead people, they go back to their graves, and it will be 1 year till they dance again. Let's hear how the French composer Camille Saint-Saëns tells this story with no words, but only music, in his great piece, Danse Macabre. Thank you.
to the Student Peace Prize ceremony. Woo! My name is Maria, and I'm honored to be your host for the Peace Prize ceremony. The ceremony started out with the Trondheim Symphony Orchestra, conducted by Torodd Wiggum. They performed Dans Macabre by Camille Saint-Saëns. The Symphony Orchestra is an inspiring and influential group of artists, and with over 100 years of history, they have performed on stages all over the world. Next, I would like to introduce to you our first speaker here tonight. Her name is Teresa Hösta. She is head of the Student Peace Prize and is one of the reasons why we are all gathered here tonight. Together with her team, she is also following up the previous winners of this honorable prize, as well as she is conveying the Majid Tavakoli's work. Please welcome her.
Dear all, ISFiT participants from all corners of the world, former and present ISFiT volunteers, Bishop Munib Yunan, the Student Peace Prize laureate of 2001, Minku Nine, members of the Student Peace Prize Committee of 2013, members of the Nomination Committee, distinguished guests and parents, I'm so happy to see you all here, and I want to thank you for the inspiring walk of peace we took together. Today, we are gathered to celebrate one person, a person who himself cannot be present. We are here to recognize the work of Majid Tavakoli. He could not witness, as I did today, how all the 116 nationalities that you represent walked peacefully together through the streets of Trondheim. We walked together not to protest, but to show our support. Majid Tavakoli is a student leader fighting for a better society for himself and others in Iran. He got imprisoned on the student day in 2009 for speaking up for a better and freer Iran. Tavakoli is a spokesperson for peaceful solutions. He believes in a democratic society based on participation and the freedom of speech. Even from prison, he is a strong voice for democracy and academic freedom. He puts a spotlight on the human rights violations he and many others are victims of. Tavakoli is a symbol of student resistance. By banning and arresting students from their studies on the basis of gender, beliefs, or peaceful activism, the Iranian authorities are violating the obligations under international law. The Iranian authorities must recognize that students, like all in Iran, have the right to peacefully express their opinions on their own or in association, and to peacefully demonstrate. This includes the right to express their criticism of the government. Tavakoli used this right, and for that he's been arrested. But still, he is not silent. We are not silent. And we will show him and the world that we have not forgotten. We will not be silent until there's justice for Majid Tavakoli. This justice we all have to work for. We all have to contribute to create peace. Peace is about talking and listening. Peace is about dialogue and understanding. The exact same things we've been doing here at Røros and the Trondheim. ISFiT and the Student Peace Prize is all about learning by listening to what others have to say. And we hope that every one of you listens. We hope that you will remember what is said. We hope that you will bring forward the voice of Tavakoli. Because through visibility and attention, we can strengthen the hopes of many. This evening, you walk together for one person. You passed a monument with his name engraved. You have contributed to a great mosaic of him in the hall. You show, we show, that Majid Tavakoli is not forgotten. We are talking once again about his voice and his work for a better future. With mere words, we can make a difference. That is why I urge you to pass them on. Previous winners of the Student Peace Prize have emphasized that they have gained a lot by receiving the prize. Confidence in their cause, trust from fellow students, acknowledgement from the international community, and maybe most important of all, hope. One former laureate is here today, Min Kunai. When he heard that he had won the Student Peace Prize while imprisoned in Burma, it gave him hope. He was not alone. Neither is Majid. Tavakoli has heard that he is the recipient of the Student Peace Prize of 2013. We have to hope that this will strengthen him and all those who believe in him. We hope that one day we will be able to invite Tavakoli to stand on this very stage, that once again we'll have the opportunity to speak to thousands of students and urge for change. And this is possible if we all do our part. In his letter, title, Let's Remain on the Side of the People, which Tavakoli wrote in 2010, he emphasized the responsibility we have as students. I read, "For you have accepted the title student to bear the responsibility in the harshest of times to uphold the moral high ground associated with it. You are the inheritors of a high tradition which, despite years and years of repression, has remained alive and vibrant. You are the model of change, bestowed with a critical mind, endowed with the courage to defend criticism, to accept criticism, and to preserve your stronghold of enlightenment. I hope that we will not let Tavakoli down. I hope we and students all over the world are able to uphold the moral high ground and continue to question the norms of today's society. There will be no change unless someone asks, why? But if we speak up, it is never too late to create change. Majid Tavakoli and the winners to come are representing hope for the future. We in this hall are also representing this hope. We are the future, and it is up to us to make it a better one for students and youth all over the world. Thank you.
Thank you, Teresa, for your inspiring words. The beautiful music we just heard is Musai Duo with Margrethe Fredheim and Uno Alexandre Vesche. Margrethe is a student at Manhattan School of Music in New York, where she is pursuing her dream to be an opera singer. Uno is a multi-talented musician who plays many different instruments, but it's the harp that is his favorite. Together, they performed the old tradition Norwegian song, Og her møter mangt. It's a song about being good to each other and being hopeful. After that, they performed a Russian folk song from Nikolai Rimsky-Korsakov about misunderstandings. With the music performed here on stage tonight, we have traveled through several countries and ages. For example, France in 18th century and Russia and Norway in 19th century. Now it's time to hear from a new part of the world. It is time to announce our special guest who has traveled all the way from Burma to Trondheim to speak to you tonight. His name is Min Ko Nang. In 2001, he received the Student Peace Prize for his fight for democracy. He is a true fighter for all the freedom of speech, just like this year's prize winner. His courageous struggle for democracy in Burma has cost him almost two decades of life spent in prison. He has become a symbol for student activism. Just recently, in 2008, Min Ko Nang and a group of students were sentenced to 65 years of prison for their role in demonstrations in Burma. But Min Ko Nang was released just a year ago and is participating in Work for Democratic Burma. Please give a warm welcome to Min Ko Nang.
Higgly Oseda. Ladies and gentlemen, I believe that this prize is awarded to honor a student who has been imprisoned for his struggle for the freedom. The prize will give us courage to continue the peace movement. When we are struggling for peace and freedom, imprisonment and other kinds of troubles are unavoidable. We have to face them. In such a situation, it becomes so important to know the recognition from the international community that we are not forgotten. We appreciate supports from the international students. It has been a long tradition that a high moral value associates with the Students' Peace Prize. I believe that this prize will become the light of Northern Star for Majid Tafakoli from Iran, who is now going through the darkest corner in the prison. I'm sure that our warm helping hands can make him stand firm when he is about to collapse. I'm telling this based on my own experience. When I was about to collapse during my time in solitary confinement. This student peace prize became the most powerful helping hands for me. Please allow me to revisit the situation I was facing in 2001. I had been in solitary confinement in a very narrow cell for 20 years at that time. I had no idea when I could be freed. I satisfied myself for being a political prisoner over one decade when I learned about a warden of this peace prize to me. I feel that it is the best recognition by the international community for those who are struggling for freedom. I had gained more strength and courage to carry on regain democracy and freedom in my country. I strongly feel that this prize was given by the international students, not only me, but also to all of fellow students in our country still fighting for freedom. I am encouraged by the fact that a precious tradition of the Student Peace Prize is still very much alive today, and sure, it will be alive in the future as well. We all, the international students' community, will be ready to cooperate for peace around the world. I truly believe that our unity and movement will become our group song for peace during our march toward free and happy lives for our goal. Thank you so much to you all.
While we reflect on these inspiring words, it's time for some music. After the music, there will be a 15-minute break before we continue. Our next performer is a local artist just from outside of Trondheim. This man uses his music to create a universe full of wizards, lost love, and candles. With his guitar and local Norwegian instruments, he is a rising star. So, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Kristoffer Øyen.
Hello, it's really nice to be here. The first song is called Trace the Sand. What happened last night? I just have to change a guitar.
The next and last song is called Rose.
Go easy down the river, just float in your own pace. There's waterfalls, it's raining downstream. I rose to be a lover. Sometimes I find it strange to why you chose a man that follows the rain. We decide we're alive, how this should go. We don't need a sweet relief, all this is over. All we need is here and now. We crave for something bigger and better as we grow old. It's how small we are, our time tries to show. But in fear of magic numbers and tricks and games to play, we nourish the sweet. Go easy down the river, just float in your own pace. There's waterfalls that's raging downstream.
Thank you.
Thank you.
That was amazing. There are so many talented artists here tonight. Let's, don't you agree? Let's give them an extra applause. The drums were played by Complete. It's one of the kind performance group. They have all previously been a part of His Majesty King's Guard. And since 2007, they've been practicing every week. So, and instead of making soldiers march on time, they actually made Norwegians dance, not an easy task, actually. And they played with together with bands such as Kaiser Orchestra and Erik and Chris. Thank you, Complete. We also heard, again, Margrethe and Uno. This time, they performed a song that is called Next Stop. And they have written this song especially for ISFiT. Very extra. This song is inspired by the ambient sounds of train station, the noisy arrival of the train, which takes us on an exciting journey. And now, the moment we all been waiting for. The reason that we are gathered here tonight. The presentation of the 2013 Student Peace Prize. In his fight for the freedom of speech and basic human rights, our Student Peace Prize recipient, Majid Tavakkole, has been imprisoned by the Iranian regime. Majid is therefore not able to be here tonight to be presented with his award. However, this will only make his voice louder, his dreams stronger, and our collective fight for human rights, democracy, and peace even more important. The Student Peace Prize Committee has, through nominations and strict procedures, elected Majid Tavakkole as this year's recipient. Erik Skreiner Evans, leader of the committee, is here tonight to elaborate the terms and conditions of the Student Peace Prize. And to explain Majid's legacy, the leader of Iranian human rights movement, Mahmoud Amiri Mogadam, has traveled to Trondheim and is here to speak to us tonight. So, please give him a welcome applause.
Good evening. My name is Erik Schreiner Evans. I am the head of the Student Peace Prize Committee. The committee has consisted of experts from Norwegian media, academia, politics, and civil society, and representatives from the National Union of Students in Norway. Firstly, I would like to thank the Nominations Committee for its professional and thorough research into the individual candidates, all deserving great recognition for their efforts and struggle. After careful consideration, the Peace Prize Committee concluded that the Student Peace Prize for 2013 be awarded to the Iranian student activist Majid Tavakkole, currently imprisoned in Rajshahr, Iran. The reasoning of the jury is as follows. Majid Tavakkole is a role model for all students dedicated to the promotion of peace and democracy around the world. The jury emphasizes Majid's continued work towards allowing students the right to participation and contribution despite the threat to his own safety. He has shown great capability to inspire and motivate others to engage themselves in the same cause. In a turbulent context dominated by violence and oppression, Tavakkole stands as a spokesperson for peaceful solutions and development through reform towards a democratic society based on participation and the freedom of speech. I would also like to take the opportunity to elaborate. In a geopolitical context dominated by confrontation between states and nations, one must not forget that democracy seldom comes about by external pressure. Democracy grows rather from within a society. Freedom is a need, a craving, embedded in all of humanity. Thus, the forces of democracy exist in all societies. Wherever democracy is absent, it still has its proponents. Majid Tavakkole is a dauntless example of such proponents. Having already served one jail sentence and knowing the risk of repeat incarceration, Majid Tabakoli still chose to speak out about the injustices he saw. There are moral absolutes. Democracy is fundamentally a moral issue. This I hold as non-debatable. However, the exact content of the term and how to best bring it about are much more complicated questions. Surely the answers to these questions depend on the local, geographical, cultural, and historical contexts. Democracy never comes about as a result from outside pressure, certainly not by the use of force. Democracy can only grow from the inside of society or a nation. Although their motives may be noble, some actors on the global stage currently seem to prescribe to a methodology of armed threats. This is not the way to go. If love for good values is the alleged motivation for violent aggression, then the logical consequence naturally becomes an undermining of those very values, thus only deepening the conflict and divide. By undermining our values, we also undermine our greatest allies. Rather than subscribing to concepts like preemptive strikes and intimidating rhetoric, we need to acknowledge internal forces, like Tabakoli, and do what we can to aid them. These are our allies. The first thing we need to do is to aid these, our brothers and sisters, our fellow students, is to recognize them, to see them, and to spread their message of a society based on values like respect, understanding, participation, equal liberties, and freedom of expression. This prize is our attempt at doing so.
زیادی از صحبتم خطاب به رهبری جمهوری اسلامی و شخص اول متاسفانه فضای سرکوب به حدیه که دوستان تحکیم از من خواستن که در باب رهبری و شخص آقای خامنه‌ای که شاید چند روز آینده در دانشگاه علم و صنعت حاضر بشه صحبتی نکنم. من از همه عذر میخوام. ما دوست داریم خودسانسوری روالی و رویه حاکم در جنبش دانشجویی بشه، ولی با توجه به درخواست دوستان میپذیریم. به هر حال ببخشید بازم. اما از تلخی‌های جامعه ایمون بگیم، چیزی که امروز ما رو دور همدیگه جمع کرده، عناد با دموکراسی، آزادی ستیزی، حق کشی، تازه خرد ستیزان در دانشگاه، سرکوب نهادهای مدنی و فعالان کارگری و معلمان، خشم بر قومیت‌ها و اقلیت‌ها، جفای بر زنان و دختران دانشگاه، اخراج اساتید دانشجویان از دانشگاه، تبعید اندیشمندان، سانسور شدید رسانه‌ای، توقیف روزنامه‌ها و نشریات، تبدیل رسانه ملی به مونولوگ حاکمیت و پر شدن زندان‌ها از آزاد اندیشان و شکنجه دانشجویان در بند و زندانیان. جنبش دانشجویی همان گونه که در سال 32 و سال 57 و تا به امروز در تمام طول حیات خیش در برابر استبداد خودکامگی در نفی ظلم و ستم ایستاده، همچنان باید بایستن و ظلم است چه محصول طاغوت شاهنشاهی باشد و چه حاکمیت ولایت نائبه.
In absence of popular support, and in order to survive the dictatorship in Iran has to spread fear among the people. They do it by persecution and arrest of activists, journalists, intellectuals, and by public executions and amputations and extensive use of violence. In this way, they appear more powerful than they actually are, and they make the people feel more powerless. It's in this context that we understand why the Iranian authorities were so threatened by Majid Tavakkoli, a peaceful 23-year-old student who just spoke about the fundamental human rights and for what they put him in solitary confinement and sentenced him to 9 years in prison and lifetime ban from education. Majid Tavakkoli's words about the human rights situation, and especially when he addresses the supreme leader, these words still shake the fundaments of the Iranian regime. His peaceful words are a much bigger threat to the regime's existence than any threat of a military intervention. His speech demonstrates that Majid and the student movement are not powerless. Today's prize is not only a prize to Majid Tavakkoli for his courage and peaceful struggle for democracy and human rights in Iran. It's also a declaration of support for all members of the Iranian student movement and all those who struggle for the basic human rights. This prize inspires them and gives them strength to continue their struggle. I am moved by this week's events in honor of Majid Tavakkoli, by seeing the pictures of the veiled male Norwegian student saying, "We are all Majid." And especially today's walk of peace through the center of Trondheim. Iranian regime put Majid in prison to shut his voice. But today, Majid's voice is louder than ever because you are his voice. I can imagine how inspiring it will be for Majid and the other members of the student movement when they hear about all these events. I can tell you that 2 days after announcement of the prize in September, the news reached the prison and it made Majid and the other prisoners very happy, and they actually celebrated it. I'm sure that this week's events would be even more inspiring to them. It gives them the strength to keep their faith in a better future while they are in captivity. The prize has also a message to Iran's supreme leader, Mr. Ali Khamenei, that the world is watching you, and you will be held accountable for what your regime is doing. I would like to say a few words to Mr. Khamenei in Farsi. آقای خامنه‌ای، شما فکر میکنید تا کی میتونید با انداختن بهترین فرزندان ایران در زندان، با سانسور، با اعدام و قطع عضو در ملأ عام به بقای حکومتتون ادامه بدین؟ یقین داشته باشید که در آینده نه چندان دور بهار ایران نیز فرا خواهد رسید و آن روز شما و دیگر مسئولین نظام باید در مقابل مردم ایران به خاطر تمام ظلم و ستمی که در این 34 ساله مرتکب شده اید جوابگو باشید. My friends, I'm certain that sooner or later the Iranian spring will arrive. And one day Majid Tavakkuli will be standing here and receiving the prize on behalf of the student movement. But until then, we are all Majid. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
The beautiful ballet performance was by Åsne Stole. She is a Norwegian dancer educated in Oslo, Paris, and United States. She is currently living in Oslo, where she works as well, and this is the first time she is dancing in Trondheim. She was accompanied by Håkon Magnar Skogstad on the piano. Before, thank you. Before I announce the next music performance, I would like to improvise a little bit. I hope they think it's okay. There are 450 volunteers working with ISFiT. There are these volunteers, all these volunteers, they work from maybe 2 years to several weeks with the festival. And I would like to say thank you to them, because they do an amazing job. They are stressed out. They do a lot of things during the weeks of before festival and during the festival, and they are kind of the heroes behind the stage. So I think we should give them a good applause. Thank you. That was great. Thank you. So, now we will hear from a band named Osk. They describe music as part of existence far from war and poverty, almost like a different planet where people throughout history has been able to visit and find safety, hope and joy. Music is where love grows, hatred vanishes, no matter what language, no matter what chord. Let us join Osk in a visit to that planet.
Hello, we're Osk. It's an honor for us to be here tonight. We are going to play two songs for you. The first one is called Black Smoke Rose.
Black smoke rose from a small house, rose into the clear air. Flew with the morning breeze, and no one knew who they were until they found a pair of teeth buried in ashes of two long-lived lives. Long-lived lives. Two long-lived lives. She met him just before she should have. Too young to marry, even though it was love. Thank you. black smoke rose from a small house, rose into the clear air, flew with the morning breeze, and no one knew who they were on till they found a pair of teeth burned in ashes of two long-lived lives, long-lived lives, two long-lived lives.
Our next song is called Wind.
You say you're poisoned, you say you're broken, but I can't see how that can be. 'Cause when you're awake, you shine like gold. Oh, you laugh at all my stupid jokes. Oh, oh. Oh, 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 oh. And I heard you talk, I heard you talk in your sleep. I heard you talk about your past. Oh, let me go, please let me go, as if you begged for mercy and fled your innocence. Oh, 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 oh. Just a band-aid hovering, the scar that never heals. Does my white lies do any good? Oh, I try so hard to seem unaffected. Oh, 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 oh.
as you sit when their lords you down, down, yeah, oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. The wind that blows you down as you sit when it lifts you up.
We are now heading towards the end of the Student Peace Prize ceremony. Today we have heard and seen how one student can make a difference in a world that is far from perfect. Every day somewhere on this planet there's war and injustice. Every day there are people who ask themselves, what is the point of the struggle? How can things be so unfair? How can people be so cruel to each other? But there is hope. There are many extraordinary people who fight against injustice and inspire many of us to act. What also gives me hope is that we live in a new world of technology. Technology that allows young people to express their ideas and challenge the regimes and other forces that want to silence them. Using the technology, we can connect with millions of young people and learn about how things are other places. So, before we pack our bags and travel to our homes, I want to ask you one thing. Please promise me that you will keep in touch. Use email, Facebook, Twitter, or something else, and send a message to each other sometimes. Keep talking to each other and expand each other's understanding of culture, politics, and everyday life. Please, make the world smaller, and all of us even closer to each other. Thank you.
Thank you.